Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome to this edition of RV Bandwagon. Well, thank you for coming on board and taking a look at my videos. Today, I've got a little problem. I'm doing the testing and retesting of all the systems on the RV. And up here, the first time I pressured up this city feed right here, it's got a pretty big leak in the back here. So I've ordered a new piece here because it has a crack on the back of this fitting right here. Yeah, so anyway, it's not a big deal. I'm going to pull it out of there, put a new one in, and I'll show you that once I get the new fitting in. Everything else seems to be working. The pump's working fine. Put water in the holding tank here. Everything inside's working. The sink's working. Shower's working. Hot water heater's working. But just one leak here, so really not too bad. Alright guys, so here I am in the old giggity rig, my safari trek, and right here, you want to see that right there? Well, this is a list right here. As you may or may not know, we're going to go on the road for at least a little while to test the waters there and actually see some places we've been wanting to see. And I recently took the rig out on a test run out to the coast. Once I got back, I created a list, and this actually has about 41 different key points that I'm going to be taking care of on this particular rig, and some of them are very major and some of them are very minor. But in any case, this is what I would like to see happen before we actually get out on the road. Even though this rig runs fine, and even though it is very tight, and except for the leak, everything is working, there still is a whole bunch of things that I would like to have taken care of in order to make me feel more confident when I'm out on the road. And it takes a little while, takes a little money, but if you do things like this, it will help you get down the road with the least amount of incidents. On my list, I have an oil change. I have a roof rack that I need to put up on the top that I just put up there to size, and it fits fine. I just got to mount it. I did my water pressure test yesterday. I've got to lube all the grease zerts on the rig. Obviously checking the hoses and belts, replacing what I need. Those look pretty good. I've already checked them out. A few other incidental things. I fired the hot water heater yesterday. It's on this list, so that's checked off. I'm going to do a tune-up on it. It runs good, but still I'm going to put some new plugs in it. I'm also going to have some extra plugs and tune-up parts for it, so that way it is easily taken care of if any of those should go wrong. I'm putting in a CB radio, possibly with a scanner in it. And maybe even a ham radio, I'm not sure. I'm doing the solar upgrades, which I'm going to try to put between 600 and 1 kilowatt of solar power on this. I have 4 deep cycle batteries for a bank. I already have 2 in here. I'm putting 2 more in. I've got to get my dinghy, my whatever you guys call a towed. I don't call it a towed. It's the dinghy, or it's the tow vehicle. Most likely I call it the tow vehicle. But anyways, it was going to be the truck. It still may be, but I'm looking at a couple possibilities there. One of them being a Jeep. I might upgrade the truck to be a Jeep. A little bit lighter, tows easier, and goes more places. So that's one of the things I'm working on. I've got a little problem with my generator fuel line. It has a leak in it. I've kind of fixed it, but I'm going to go ahead and replace that hole generator fuel line from where it actually comes from the tank in the back all the way up to the front. I'm putting a compressor in here, a fairly large compressor that will take care of any air needs that I might have. And then of course your standard stocking the rig with the essentials and survivals. I'm going to be doing major cleanouts on all the vents, all the exterior lighting. I'm going to go ahead and pull all the covers and make sure all the interiors of the lights are cleaned and all the lights are working, and most likely change out a lot of the bulbs to LEDs. Just basic other little things that you might want to think about. Water purifier, I want to have one of those on board. Flares, reflector vest, radios, cones, flashlights, auxiliary water, auxiliary gas, all these things. And then I got to have things made for the business that are actually part of this whole thing. So I'm doing new flyers, some new cards, and a couple other things to enhance the possibility of getting gigs along the way. And as you can see, I've even made a logo. It's hard to see. I'll show you right here. But I've made this logo right here because it's inspiration. If you have a baseball team or you have an organization, if you have a logo or if you have something like this right here, it basically gives you a little bit of identification, even for yourself, to say, hey, I'm doing something, here it is, here's a representation of that. It kind of makes you go forward a little bit more. So anyways, I've done that, along with all the other many things I've done to the rig, it's been quite the process to get this particular rig ready to do something like go out on the road full time. And as you can see, I'm still not quite there, but it's all a process. So if you're planning on going full time RVing, just remember that you're going to get the RV, but then after you get the RV, you've got to get it ready. Okay, so there's quite a process in turning your regular RV from, you know, standard off the showroom to something you can actually live in and something that will sustain you through a lot of different situations. So that's what I'm doing here. I just thought I'd share this little tip. Make a list, check it twice, and find out who is naughty or nice. Oh, different thing. Anyways, guys, that's about it from RV Bandwagon. Hope you're having a wonderful day and you're living your dreams like you should be, and you're doing the things in life that you were designed to do. You know what I'm saying? You feel it. Things you were designed to do. So, you know, do those things, live the dream, become who you are. All right, people, that's about it. RV Bandwagon.